couple of weeks that you guys were doing well as a team?
We're trying to carry over being fast and physical, and special teams makes the difference, so we're trying to be good in that, all three facets of football, and anything else, just be ourselves and fly free.
What have you seen from Valparaiso on tape? What are the coaches stressing that you guys are going to have to do well this Friday to counter what they do?
They're big and physical, and we're going to have to confront them with being big and physical, too.
When you take a look at practice this week, what are some of the things that you guys are really stressing in practice? What are some of the things you are legitimately working on to get ready for Friday?
Just taking it to them and working on things we've worked in the past weeks with just the other teams and using that to help out in this game.
I know it's 5A and last year was 4A, but how does making a deep run in the state tournament last year prepare you for the stage, prepare you for competition levels? How does that experience help you guys this time around?
We know what it's like to play in the off season and go on deep runs, so we plan to use that and all the years behind us to help us in this game and go play at Valparaiso.
Obviously, Valpo put up 49 points last week, so as a defense, what do you guys need to do to hold them down and make sure that you've taken care of your side of the football come Friday night?
We're just going to stop the run and stop the big plays.
We just work hard on everything we do. Like, each step is day by day. We push each other. We go out every scout play and every play, actually. We give it our best, so no matter what, we're just giving it our all.
Okay, so obviously, what position you play again?
Running back.
Okay. Offensively, you guys came out hot start last week.
Yeah.
How do you go about doing that again this coming week? Because, obviously, Valparaiso put up points. They put up 49 last week.
Yeah. Basically, we're just going to give it our all. I mean, each play matters, so we're going to have to focus on the details and focus on, what we have to get done. So.
What makes this offense click? I feel like in the last couple of weeks, you guys have really started to play some of your best football of the season.
Yeah, it's just the brotherhood that we have with each other. Like, we know each other. We're friends outside and inside of the gym. So we're always, pushing each other. We're always talking to each other, helping each other on homework. So it doesn't really matter, what we're doing. We're always together. So we're just a bunch of friends.
What have you seen on tape that concerns you about Valparaiso, and what are some of the things that you guys are tangibly working on in practice this week to get prepared for what they present on the defensive side?
Well, we know they're a tough team. They're undefeated, so we obviously know that they have the skills and stuff, but we're just going to focus on the step-by-step plays, So, I mean, we're just going to give it our best like any other team. We respect all, we fear none, so just going to work it.
Final question for me, obviously last year was 4A, but making a deep run in the state tournament, winning a state championship, playing games on a big stage, how does that help you this time around, knowing that you kind of have experience of what it's like to play football deep in November and what it's like to play huge games that are win or go home?
Yeah, well, I haven't played. This is my first year playing, but the team, they've been through this before, so they know what it's like. So I don't think they're scared. No one's scared. We're just going to give it our best look.
What do you try to carry over from the past couple of games into this Friday night's game when you travel up to Valpo?
First thing is attitude. That's the thing we've been most impressed with these guys is their willingness to travel, as you mentioned, and then be ready to go. We've come out of the gate pretty strong in the last couple games and playing physical. I think if it was a number one tradition we want to take on the road with us, that is to play physical football. And guys have responded. They trust in one another. They're unified. I think we're at a very good place as far as how we're playing the game right now.
The first half against Harrison, you guys came out, led 28-0 at the half. Kind of, I don't want to say put it away early, but you guys staked yourself to an early lead. How do you go about doing that, getting another fast start this week, which might be crucial in a game that's on the road like this?
Yeah, we're trying to keep everything the same. Even our schedule is exactly the same. So I think when you do something that well and then guys begin to buy into that and believe in it, keep as much of that process the same as possible, trust in our seniors and cut them loose on Friday.
Defensively, what's the key? Because you look at Valpo last week, they played a good Mishawaka team and they scored 49 points.
Yeah.
How do you limit them? What are some of the things you have to do to hold that point total down?
Well, obviously we've got to stop the run. They throw it well, but I think as far as what they like to do, they like to run the ball, and that's going to set up their run. So, we got to do everything we can to take that away. They got a lot of speed. They got great size up front. So we got to stop the run and then be able to, you know, make the adjustments when they throw the ball. So, you know, it's very similar week to week for us. You know, do what we do, try to take away the things they like to do and see what happens from there.
Kind of piggybacking on that, your front seven had a great game last week, especially in the first half. How key is it for those guys to set the tone for what you guys do? I mean, not only just defensively, but set the tone for the physicality of the game on a Friday.
It's vital. I mean, that's the kingpin of Bishop Dwenger football is the front seven, defense, physical, fast football. You hit it on the head. I mean, that's exactly we gauge our ability to have success on what those guys can do.
Final question, what are you most looking forward to about this Friday? I mean, this is a team that has responded the past 2 years in big games, and it's another big game on Friday night.
Yeah, we were looking, you know, these seniors, this is 40-plus game. I think it's 42nd game for them, which is unbelievable. So we trust that they're going to be ready. What a tremendous opponent, you know, going into this game with a team that we've never played before, to an environment we've never been before. So from that standpoint, it's exciting. We know it's going to be a great challenge, and we're going to go up there and cut it loose and see what happens.
Anything else you'd like to add?
No, thanks. Thanks for the coverage.